Prince George's County, Maryland, a restaurant remained open while there was a dead body inside the bathroom for hours. Police received a call around 6:30 p.m. on Wednesday for a woman found unconscious inside this Largo, Maryland Jasper's restaurant. Medics who responded to the scene said the patron most likely died of a heart attack. According to the police report, the women's bathroom was closed off to customers. However, the men's bathroom remained open for everybody else to use. Jasper's was full, the report said, and tables were being seated while the woman laid lifeless in the restroom. Miguel Perea, one of the managers at Jasper's, told Fox 5 DC the restaurant was protecting the family's privacy. Perea said, at the moment, we thought we were doing the right thing and we realized maybe we were wrong. The owner, Fred Rosenthal, said the coroner did not arrive until 2 hours later and the woman's body was eventually removed from a side door of the restaurant. The management at Jasper's told Fox 5 they feel horrible about what transpired on Wednesday. They are in the process of trying to find the woman's family members to apologize and see how they can best support them at this time. Yesterday, Jasper's restaurant released a policy. They said, quote, last night, one of our customers tragically passed away within our establishment. On behalf of our ownership, management, and staff, we send the sincerest and most heartfelt support and condolences to the deceased family. We will be reaching out to the family to see if there is any way we can support them in this time of grief. The statement continued to say, quote, we immediately contacted county authorities and followed their protocol and procedure. Under the authorities' guidance, we closed the area to patrons until all emergency services could arrive and followed the direction of the authorities. All right, so they wanted to keep serving lunch, or I guess it was dinner, 6:30 p.m. People are eating. Well, there is a woman who has died, likely of a heart attack, in the bathroom. And it goes to show that they really didn't want people to know about this because they were using the side door. They were like, don't worry about the dead body, just carry on, keep enjoying your meal. Rick, would you be okay with eating in this kind of a situation?
No.
What?
I wouldn't.
You know, Jessica, what I like about you is you ask the hard-hitting questions.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, I'm kidding. Like, no, like obviously not. Of course not. No. What I find rather interesting, and I it's public, so I'm gonna say it. The owner's name here is Fred Rosenthal. Fred, what are you doing, man? Fred, you really think if someone tragically passes away from what police is saying is cardiac arrest, you really think it's appropriate to just being like, order for table 5? Like, come on, man. Really? That's how we're gonna do this? How I see it, they didn't wanna lose the money. That's how I saw it. They were in a panic and they didn't wanna lose the money. So they kept everyone there and, you know, made it seem like everything was kumbaya when it wasn't. His quote was, we didn't want to create curiosity. Bro, people would be curious. It would be better than this. It would be better than people finding out like, wait a minute, I ate like a Bobert style hamburger after someone like passed away in the bathroom. And the person who brought this to our attention and to the mainstream attention even said that there were police that were standing outside of the bathroom. Already, you gotta be suspicious. So fail on behalf of Jasper's, mega fail.
Yeah, I'm trying to find what the menu is at this restaurant. I'm investigating the death actually right now. I wanted to pull up the menu to figure out maybe they didn't want people to think that their food could cause a heart attack. They didn't want to lose their customers. Imagine someone dies of a heart attack in the bathroom and you're eating like, I don't know, like a burger, cheese, fries, whatever, and you just have a reckoning and you're like, you know what? I gotta stop eating like this so I don't end up like her. You know? Mm-hmm. It is an American restaurant. When you talk about Bobert style burgers, I mean, it's a lot of mac and cheese, it's a lot of fried stuff, burgers, wings, you know, the type of stuff that if you eat it too much, doctors say you're at a greater risk for a heart attack. But yeah, they definitely wanted to make money. I'm thinking of my time as a server and bartender, and when you're in the weeds, the restaurant's full. I can imagine just in passing, like two waitresses or a waiter and a waitress just passing each other and like, oh, gee, a woman died in the bathroom. It's like, oh no, yeah. Can you bring silverware to table five? Like when you're in the weeds, you're in the weeds, and the owner and the manager should have handled this much better. Like the staff, including them in the apology, doesn't make much sense. They were not complicit in this. The waiters and waitresses have no power in this situation.
Agreed. I mean, I was a table wiper at one point. I could tell you the employees have very little say.
Yeah.
Very, very little say.
Yeah. And like to not use the front door, I get it. You don't want to bring a woman's body through people, but like emergency services arriving at the scene when someone's unconscious in the bathroom, they should get in the fastest way possible. I just have a feeling being on the phone and being like, hey, by the way, could you use the side door? It's just like, we got a business to run here. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's this, the details of this don't seem so good for the restaurant owners.
I can also tell you that when I took pizza orders over the phone and was also a pizza boxer in the kitchen, I could tell you that there was like that back door that went to the parking lot. So like there, you know, there is potential there is what I'm saying. But like business practices, this is an example of what not to do if unfortunately tragedy strikes your establishment. This is idiotic. Like I would be hard pressed to ever go back there again if I was there on that dais.